think the fundamental, one of the fundamental principles of Buddhism, or the Dharma, as it tends to get called by Buddhists, from a practical point of view, is that we are constantly changing, and that we can learn to direct the course of that change ourselves. We can look at the conditions that bring about certain states of mind, and we can set the conditions to change those states of mind in a more positive, happy, creative direction. Quite often people come to Buddhism through wanting to learn to meditate, but really meditation is only one aspect of Buddhist practice. It's a very important one, but if we really want to make progress with Buddhism, or with meditation even, we need to look at the whole way we're living our lives and all of our behaviour, and bring that in accordance with principles and values. And we need to try and bring awareness to all of our activities. And if we're able to do that, then if we do choose to engage in meditation, we'll have a much more deep, satisfying experience of that. And then our experience of meditation will lead into our whole experience of life, and we'll gradually find that our character is being transformed.
A lot of people come to learn to meditate because they want to become less stressed or have a calmer life. And that's a very good and normal motive. One of the things that meditation brings is that, in a sense, you become less stressed and you develop calmness or clarity. But it's not a calmness of silence, or it's not a calmness of nothing happening. It's more of a calmness of being one-pointed. It's more of a calmness of being fully engaged in anything that you're doing at any one time. So meditation can bring clarity, meditation can bring a more direct, a more honest, a more positive relationship with other people. Another quality that meditation brings is a sense of power, or a sense of being in control of your life. That can be a sense of having an intellectual clarity, having a rational understanding of your life, of what's happening, or it can be a sense of, well, or an experience of that your emotions and your intellect are working more as a whole, working more as one entity. So there's less conflict in your life, there's more clarity, you know what you're doing, you know why you're doing it. So meditation's about paying attention to our experience, paying attention to our life, paying attention to the effect that our actions, the effect that our life is having on us, intellectually, emotionally, in terms of our relationships with others, simply in terms of our enjoyment of life. In some ways, I think there's a lot of talk about suffering in Buddhism. Suffering is a very good indication of the effect that your actions are having on you as a human being.
Suffering, or dukkha is the Buddhist term, which can mean suffering of a sort of more extreme kind, or it can just mean a vague sense of dissatisfaction. If we can notice this in our experience, it can tell us something very important, which is that somehow we've got something wrong about the world, that we are not experiencing things as they really are. What the Buddha claimed is to have seen things as they really are and freed himself from dukkha, from suffering, from dissatisfaction. He still had a body, his body still gave him pain, but his mind was somehow, in some way that perhaps it's not easy to comprehend, was liberated from that, from all craving and grasping, from all wishing things to be other than they are.
For me, the important principle of meditation is that we pay attention, that we simply stop and we're honest. What is happening? What is my experience? There's another side to meditation, which is about positive emotion, which is about looking at our experience with kindness. Or you could say experiencing our experience with kindness. So if we look at our life with honesty and with clarity and with kindness, we can see, well, how happy are we? What is the quality of our relationships with other people? And I think for me, a lot of people ask me, how do I know that meditation is working? And for me, there's only one answer. You know your meditation is working because your relationships with other people are getting better. you're feeling more clear, you're feeling more whole in your relationships with other people. Having a spiritual dimension in your life is about being wholehearted. It's about being fully engaged with what you're doing whilst you're doing it. And that means basically being integrated. You know what you're doing, you know why you're doing it, and largely you are happy to be doing it, you want to be doing it. You can only know that to be happy to be doing something, you have to know what you think about it, you have to know what you feel about it. So you need to pause and you need to keep coming back, well, what is my experience? In Buddhism, you learn about life through engaging with life, engaging with other people, engaging with your interests, your passions, and learning from that experience.
I think people have always needed a deeper perspective on their lives. I think there's a number of reasons why Buddhism is an important voice that I hope will become more widely heard in the modern world. One is that it's so explicitly and clearly anti-consumerist, and as we're using up the Earth's resources at such an alarming rate, a worldview which encourages the positive benefits of simplicity and renunciation and contentment is badly needed. Also, I think we need a widespread propagation of values. If the conflicts and potential for mutual destruction are to be overcome in the modern world, it's not so much that human beings are more wicked than we've ever been, but our ability to harm one another is greater than it's ever been, and there's more of us, and they're going to be more still. So we need a kind of a philosophy, a lived philosophy that emphasises harmonious living, harmonious amongst fellow human beings, and a harmonious relationship with the planet that supports us.
I think we can only find that through, well, looking at our own conscience. Vidyaruchi talks about a harmonious relationship with the planet and with life. For me, we have to look at, well, what makes us happy? What makes us feel alive, connected to ourselves, to other people, to the world? And what makes our conscience feel at ease and at peace? If we're behaving in a way that damages ourselves or damages others or damages our planet, on some level, that is going to cause us a little disquiet, or maybe a lot of disquiet. A lot of people don't sleep at night. A lot of people don't know why they don't sleep at night. With meditation, we get an opportunity just to really pay attention to the effect that our life is having on ourselves and on those around us.